There are three cardinal properties of frames. The first property is that frames represent stereotypes. Now, we all know about stereotypes. We deal with stereotypes all the time. Here is a stereotype for the verb eat or ate. In this particular stereotype, the slots are dealing with our stereotypical, my stereotypical notion of what happens when something is eaten. There is a subject and there is a frog. There is a location, there is a time. You may have a different set of stereotypes. In fact, stereotypes often are very culture specific. Second, frames provide default values. So not only do they have the slots which come from our notions of a stereotype of this particular verb, but the many of these slots may have values already filled in. As an example, I may already have a default value which says that after the object has been eaten, it is no longer alive. It is inside the subject's stomach, and the subject's mood is now happy. These are all default values. Of course, when you have defaults, you can also have exceptions to them. As an example, it may be that when Ashok ate a frog, it made him sad because frogs don't suit him very well. Now, this exception handling is both very powerful and a problem. It is powerful because I can have stereotypes with default values, and when needed, I can override the default values. But it's also a problem because you can see what will happen. The more instances I have, the more times I'll be overriding some default values, and then I have to worry about how to manage all of this exceptional handling. Nevertheless, frames provide a very nice way of capturing both default values and exception handling. The third cardinal property of frames is that they exhibit inheritance. So I can organize these frames in a frame hierarchy. Here is a frame for an animal, and then that has two subclasses, a frame for an ant and a frame for a human. Note I'm using the language of classes and subclasses here. Now, inheritance works in that I may have some slots for the class animal, and then I may specify for the ant more specific values for some of those slots. For example, number of legs is 6 or the number of arms is 0. But the important thing is that I inherited these slots from the superclass. Of course, when I specify the subclasses, when I go down this frame hierarchy, I may keep on adding additional slots. So for a human, I may also add the job in the name. These classes then may have instances. As an example, Ashok is the name of the person and the job is a professor. And so these instances are also inheriting all the slots and the slot values from the class.
We can also see that when frames provide default values, that's very similar to a constructor when we're dealing with object-oriented programming that supplies some initial values when an object is first instantiated. So it seems like there's actually a very rich connection between classes and frames here.
David, that's a very good point. In fact, there is a history to it. Frames and object-oriented programming came about the same time in the 1960s and the 1970s, and I'm sure they influenced each other in both directions.